Greetings, travelers, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play Splatoon Amiibo Challenge Edition, presented by Draco Breach. Last time we beat Tier 3, and this time we are going to tackle Tier 4. Now, with my E3 hit list out of the way, I thought about what I would like to talk about because there's nothing really to talk about with the challenges anymore. And I felt, well, why not bring up some very good-looking games coming out of Kickstarter? All of them having meteoric rises. Specifically, I am talking about... okay. Banjo-Kazooie's successor, spiritual successor. Yooka-Laylee. What I love about Playtonic Games is that they are the original developers for Banjo-Kazooie. They came from Rareware, pretty much out of frustration of not being able to develop the games that they wanted to develop. And they are not being bitter. They are producing a game that is going to be fun for a lot of people. And they are not being bitter about it. And I like that they're not being bitter. I really do. Because the game is coming to the Nintendo Wii U, the PS4, and the Xbox One. Am I gonna... Nope. Which means that I probably missed out on that power-up. Oh well. Well, I could go back and get it, but I don't care. But Yooka-Laylee stars the characters Yooka and Laylee. Yooka being the male lizard, and Laylee being the female bat. And the developers are keeping to their tradition of putting googly eyes on everything and claiming that they don't know how to name things, because you have collectibles called pages. And I am a big fan of collectathon, so I am happy to have a developer dedicated to making a good collectathon again. Because there really aren't that many out there. Now, arguably, of course, you have the possibility of Ratchet and Clank Remastered scratching that collectathon itch. So, that's one game definitely worth looking forward to. But, in general, I really like the former Rareware developers who are the current members of Playtonic Games. And they have a lot to say about their game as well. They are very vocal, very active. I wonder what's in that now. Because I haven't actually looked at any of the... Am I not going to be able to hit the wall? I thought I would be... Okay, I'm not going to be able to hit the wall. And fortunately, during E3, they revealed a bit more. Including a working demonstration of a level. Oh, this is not gonna... Ugh. But I'm gonna find... Oh, just points. Oh well. That works too. So there's a lot of work, a lot of love going into the development of Yooka-Laylee, so I am very much looking forward to that. And what I love about it as well is, basically, you have a developer who is told that their style of game would not be popular among gamers, and it was one of several record-setting projects on Kickstarter. Another one being released. Oh! Okay, that was dangerous. Another one being released around the same time was Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, which is from another famous developer who I can never remember the name to because of what everybody calls him. They pretty much just call him Iga or Igavania. Igavania being something that came from what he birthed with the Metroidvania genre. He was told by Konami that nobody wanted a Metroidvania game, and he set out to prove them wrong with the wonderful folks at Inti Creates, who have a history of making indie titles. Let's see how... Okay, you're gonna be interesting, aren't you? That works. But that game had quite the interesting history to follow, because you had a lot of people asking, well, where's the Nintendo Wii U love? Why don't you have a stretch goal for the Nintendo Wii U? And it turned out that they really did. They just didn't want to talk about it immediately. And it did finally come to the Wii U. Well, finally reached the Wii U stretch goal. That didn't work. I'm not close enough, apparently. Which was $3 million. I did watch a lot of people complain about how that campaign was going, but honestly, the fact that they did put the Wii U on there, and they seem to have an active campaign planned out for it. Oh, this is gonna be interesting. This challenge, taking out snipers might be a little bit easier as a sniper. I find that interesting. Let's see here. So I watched that campaign quite closely. Okay, you saw me. Oh, you're gonna clean that up. And it was a popular campaign. And for obvious reasons, people want a game like that. People want to be able to play a fun game that is focused around elements like the Metroidvania games are focused around. And it succeeded beyond what I'm sure Konami's wildest expectations were, because they were probably expecting it to fail. Considering that they, from what I understand, refused... I think his name is Igarashi now that I think about it. Refused to fund Rao. To fund a game that he came to them for, because if I remember correctly, I think I heard that... Oh good, I did not die. That he actually went to Konami with part of the idea for Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, based more on, of course, a franchise that Konami owns, being the Castlevania franchise, but still similar in concept and story to what we got, ended up getting with Bloodstained. Oh, this is gonna be... I need to get out of the way. So that was a missed opportunity from Konami, which of course sounds familiar because we have the missed opportunity from Capcom with Mighty No. 9. Is this surface paintable? Yes, it is. So I think I can, yeah, I can use that. So these companies don't seem to understand their user base as much as they think they do. And more power to the creators of Mega Man and Castlevania for going out there and proving these companies wrong and making games that gamers want, that everybody said, oh no, nobody wants to play this game. And good on you, Playtonic, for giving us a new collectathon, because I need to feed that collectathon itch. I'm sure A Hat in Time will do a good job with that, as my Let's Play of the beta, I hope, proved. Where are you? There you are. Because I had a lot of fun playing through that beta. And I really want them to continue making a wonderful product. Okay, getting out of the way. So, if you can't tell, I have backed both Ukulele and Bloodstained Ritual of the Night, and I am looking forward to both those games. One game that I have not backed, and that's primarily because I never got to play the original games, was Shenmue 3. Now, if somebody can point to an easy way for me to be able to experience Shenmue 1 and Shenmue 2, I would be very appreciative. Because I don't know enough about the games to really say if I want to back it or not. Not because I doubt that they're good games, but because I have never had a chance to play them. I was wondering when you were going to get into range for me. So, again, if anybody has an easy way for me to get access to those games, please tell me, because they don't appear to be on the PSN, so I can't easily just access it. That's a lot easier to take her out that way. So it's not exactly easy to just access it. No, I don't think there's an easy way to get up to that, because it's not on PSN, and buying the physical copies is expensive. Oh, you're up there, okay. I am hoping that you make a mistake and get into my crosshairs. Come on. You know you want to. You know you want to be a bad AI. I almost made a mistake there. Armor, 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 armor. Yeah, that didn't help. Die! Jeesh, wow. Let's actually go ahead and get some more easy points here. So, Shenmue 3 is actually another example of a meteoric rise in funding, because it had $2 million in, what, 9 hours? Something like that? So, again, good on, I believe his name is Yu. So good on Yu for getting out there and getting something funded that, again, fans were obviously wanting. Now, to make the cycle complete, what we need is something related to Mega Man Legends 3. Although, hopefully that's not something that Capcom... Hopefully... Oh, wait, I don't need to worry about this. Hopefully Capcom is not going to go, oh, well, nobody wanted Mega Man, so we're not going to make Mega Man games anymore, traditional Mega Man games anymore, and saw Mighty No. 9, and they think about it, it's like, you know what, maybe people do want Mega Man, and maybe we should make a Legends game. Oh, no, 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 no. So, I don't know that if Capcom is going to do something like Sega did and give Inafune access to the Mega Man 3 IP so that he can make the game. But there is always hope. There is always something to look forward to. These gold teeth are gonna be... This is gonna be an interesting round. Okay. So, Tier 4 is taken care of. And we can move forward to Tier 5 and the 15-minute boss fights. That is the Octobot King. Ba-ba-ba. I want a plush of that Zapfish. Oh, and a new arcade game, Squid Ball. And with that, Tier 5 is coming up. So, Draco Breach reporting out. God bless and safe travels.